So, very good afternoon to all. I'm Ravina Parmar. Today I'm presenting a topic from American Literature in which I'm selected the topic Eco-critical reading of the novella The Old Man and Sea by Ernest Hemingway. Table of content. Objective of my presentation. Interpreting a text through an eco-critical lens with an eye towards nature, examine an eco-critical trope within the text. How nature is represented in this text. How the natural setting is portrayed in the novella. Introduction of the author, Ernest Miller Hemingway. He was an American novelist, short story writer, journalist, and sportsman. He was noted both for the intense masculinity of his writing and for his adventure and widely publicized life. His sufficient and lucid prose style extend a powerful influence of American and British fiction in 20th century. That is written by Philip Young. He was awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1954. So, what is eco-criticism? The term eco-criticism was coined by William Rucret in 1978. Rucret published an essay titled Literature, an Ecology and Experiment in Eco-criticism. Eco-criticism, also known as eco-critical criticism and green criticism, is a rapidly emerging field of literary study and considered the relationship and relationship that human beings have to the environment. Taking an eco-critical approach to a topic means asking questions not only a primary source such as literature, but asking larger questions about central attitude towards definition and nature. So there is a definition by Claude Feltri. Eco-criticism is the study of relationship between literature and physical environment. And moving further in our next slide, as Kellrick Goldfeltri noted, the introduction to the eco-criticism reader, just as the eco-criticism is just a feminist criticism examines language literature from a gender conscious perspective, and Marxist criticism brings an awareness of modes of production and economic class to its reading text. So in that way, Sam, environmental critic, explore how nature and the natural world are imagined through literary text. Moving further, after many years, a slow development of eco-critical consciousness took a shape, and organization on known as the Association of the Study of Literature and Environment, famous as ASLE. So now, Eco-criticism and Old Man and the Sea. In the title of the novel, we come to see that the conflict between humanity and the natural element. Humanity is represented by the old man, and the sea it represents natural element. The whole text work and see that nature presence is very influential. Nature plays an important role in Hemingway's The Old Man and the Sea. The major setting of the novel is in the wilderness of the sea. We can say that old man's relationship with the creature are nature friendly, but he lacks eco-critical consciousness, as we noted in the novel, that we come to know that old man who has a friendly friend relationship with nature, but in that sense, he was also lack of eco-critical consciousness. He is united with his environment. We find that he knows the sea very well. It seems that Hemingway is aware of the fact that everything has a role to play in this world. As like Santiago play a role to catch a marlin, and marlin play a role that Marlin should escape from the old man. And Shark's role is that to eat to satisfy his need. Sharks are represented as a powerful position because of their strength. Here we can say that Santiago is trying to empower Marlin. At the same time, Shark empowered oppressed Santiago's will. That we can see there. But in spite of his closeness with nature, he is not aware of the fact that killing the endangered species like Marlin, even if it is not dangerous, then also to kill any animal, it leads to a breakdown as well as a disorganization of the environmental structure. So, in conclusion, I want to say that Hemingway himself has an ambivalent attitude towards nature. The picture I'm showing later, by the manner of his description of his environment in Old Man and the Sea, it seems that he is very close to nature and he likes the natural environment. By the manner of this glorifying the killing of fish, it reflects that he is not aware of ecological balance. We can say that at the same time, he is aware of the man's helplessness in front of nature. At the end of the story, Santiago returns to the harbor with the skeleton of fish. From Santiago, Hemingway makes us aware that a representation of human being going against the element of nature, that is very dangerous. That is very dangerous. So there is the picture in which we can say that Santiago wasn't aware that he had met a disaster in the cycle of nature. And also, here we connect autobiographical reading, that Hemingway also not aware about it. In picture we can see that. Another picture is there. That is from Ernest Hemingway photograph collection, John F. Kennedy Presidential Library. Book citation. Thank you so much.
Okay, good. Well cited. Citations are also proper and well argued. Good one.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.